Hey guys, it's Kelly. Welcome back. Today I've got an all new Shop My Stash, my second one in this new space. I'm really excited about this. I'm excited to switch out my makeup. So if you've never seen this series from me before, this is where I make myself a little mini makeup basket that I focus out of for 3 weeks typically. I always start these videos off reflecting on my last makeup basket. I'll share with you guys my thoughts on any of the products that I was using. And then in the second half of the video, you will watch me select the new basket. So if you're just here to see that portion, I do always have a timestamp in the description box where you can skip ahead. If you're new here, hello, my name is Kelly. Here on this channel, we love talking about cruelty-free beauty. So if you're into this content, be sure to subscribe and let's go ahead and hop into it. I normally like the Stoke brand cold brew, but I wasn't able to get that. So I tried the Khalifa cold brew. I don't think I like it. And I was talking to my friend about it the other day and she's like a big coffee fanatic, and I was telling her I got this one and I don't think I like it. And she said she didn't like it either. I used to make my own cold brew. Sometimes I do, but I didn't bring my little pitcher that I make it in. Maybe I'm gonna have to start making my own again. What is your favorite cold brew brand? I'm convinced that the Stoke cold brew is the best, but I wasn't able to get it recently. Let's start off with what I'm wearing on my eyes today. This was my most reached for. Surprisingly, I thought it would be Natasha Denona Mini Glam because you guys know how obsessed with this palette I am, but I reached for these two the most by far. And if you've watched any of my recent videos in the last couple weeks when I was using this basket, you have probably noticed a pink and red theme that has been the majority of what I've been wearing, which I will say has been amazing because I love pinks these days. I didn't used to, you guys know that. But I'm thinking for this new basket, I want to go a completely new direction. I'm thinking I want to do a blue. I've been picturing a blue winged liner. That's the look that I'm planning in my head, so we're going to pick that when we get to the basket. But let's talk about this palette. I've had so much fun reaching back into this. This is the Deuce from Juvia's Place. They're not making this anymore, but sometimes I can still find it to link. Sometimes I can't. I really believe that this palette was so ahead of its time because if it came out right now, I feel like it would be such a hot seller because not only are these pastel tones really trendy, I actually would say more like a few months ago or a year ago, but definitely trendier now than when this palette launched. But also these shades, the green and then this like bluish silver, they're very, very sparkly. Like that's what's in right now, I feel like, where it's not a metallic finish, it's a glittery sparkly finish. And that's what I have on my eyes today. I did these two shades in my outer corner, and then I did this silvery blue in the inner portion of the lid. This is such a fun shade because if you use it on its own, you can see today it looks a bit more silver, but if you top it with the duochrome, you can get a very blue effect. So when I did my Q&A video, you guys saw me using this palette and I did the green plus this bluish silver with the duochrome on top, and it ended up looking like a blue-green multi-shadow look, and it looked really cool. With the shade selection and especially this duochrome, even with only 9 pans, like you can do so much with this palette. I've done a lot of pink looks this past rotation, mostly pink. You guys saw me film that one green look. I really thought I would do more green looks with this palette because that's what I'm normally reaching into from this, but we went full-blown pink this rotation. Ooh, the other look I have in my head, see? Okay, since this past rotation was so pink and red heavy, I'm ready to go the next, like the opposite direction with this next basket. I also want to do like a grungy, like dirty golden green color. That's another look I have in my head. I'm getting ahead of myself though, we'll get there. The Rosy palette, you guys saw me mention this in my summer favorites, like my favorites and fails video. I'll leave that down below if you haven't seen it yet. I reached for this so much. I did some very simple looks with this. I did some very bold looks with this. I actually have a like chatty get ready with me coming. I'm thinking the day after this video, I think it's gonna be the next video you see, and I used this palette in that. I just think this is such a beautiful palette. I love it so much. Also with the Mini Glam, I did a lot of pretty simple looks out of this one like I normally do. I didn't really reach for this one that much on camera on my filming days. I feel like I mostly was reaching for this when I'm not, when I wasn't filming, just for like a simple everyday look. I usually mix these two shimmers together on the lid, and sometimes I put a little bit of this shimmer in the outer corner. I feel like because it's only 5 pans and they're so well selected, the looks, they just kind of make themselves. Like I feel like I never have to think when I reach into this palette, it just kind of makes itself. This rotation has made me fall back in love with this. This is the foundation from Bite Beauty. It is their Changemaker. I wear L20 And with this, the finish is a little bit more matte, but right now when it's so sweaty, I mean, not as much this week, finally getting a little bit better, but for a few weeks there, it was very, very warm here. So I was preferring this formula a lot because it did keep me slightly more matte on these very, very warm days. It's also super long wearing. I just feel like it looks very natural on the skin. The foundation I'm wearing today is the e.l.f. Flawless Finish Foundation. I wear this one in the shade Natural, another one of my favorites. I actually think I'm pretty close to being out of this. I noticed when I was getting ready today, I was trying to pump it and some pumps, nothing was coming out. And you know, it starts like spitting out the product. That's how you know, like you're near the end. Actually, let me take the cap off and we'll have a look. See, oh yeah. I can see the bottom. Okay, I'm almost out of this. Maybe I should leave it in for another rotation to try to finish it. It's a pretty small bottle. You'll go through this faster than others because a typical foundation is 1 fluid ounce, whereas this one is only 0.68 fluid ounces. So there's not a lot of product here. That's probably why I'm almost done with it, but it's such a good foundation, especially for $6. My bronzer, I've fallen back in love with this one. This is the Milk Makeup Bronzing Stick. I have mine in the shade Baked. I've had this for so long. I mean, I don't think it's expired. It smells fine, it works fine. But this product is just so gigantic. You will never use up the full size. Actually, I won't say never, because I watched Nicole Renee, who I follow on Instagram and I love so much. She posted like a month or two ago that she completely used one up. So it's possible. Some of you guys have told me that you've used it up as well. But it would take using a lot of this every single day as like your only bronzer to get there because there's so much product here. It's the bronzer I'm wearing today. I just feel like it's really natural. Lately I've kind of been doing creams first and then powders on a few of the products. So for example, if I did like a cream blush and bronzer beneath and then I did like my powders on top, sometimes I would evaluate the look and say, you know what, I could do a little bit more blush and then do a powder blush on top. And I know that seems like so many extra steps, but I feel like the result is so natural. It's really beautiful and it's so long wearing. Like if you're going to do a cream and then put a powder of the same type of product over top, it is going to last all day, especially these days when it's hot, long days. That'll definitely lock it in, but I do get that that's kind of like a lot of extra steps. I don't always do that, but when I do, I've been loving the result. I've also had in this face palette from the Lip Bar. I have mine in the shade Go Off. This is the lightest version. There are 6 different shade variations of this palette. And today, I'm actually wearing every single thing in this palette today. I've used this under my eyes. This is my blush, plus a little bit of my Essence blush for my Project Pan. This is my bronzer, plus the Milk bronzer. I know, so many. But this highlighter has become my new favorite brow bone highlight. I went away from brow bone highlighting and now I'm getting back into it. I plucked my brows the other day. They're not looking too perfect today, so just ignore this, but they've been a little better recently. I went a little bit thinner. I'm going back to a thinner brow. I think just my brows naturally are pretty thin and I'm convinced that everyone looks best with a brow that's pretty similar to their own brow. So if you naturally have full brows, you probably look amazing with full brows. But if you naturally have pretty thin brows, that probably is what fits your face. So I'm getting back to a thinner brow. And with that look, I love a brow bone highlight underneath because it just kind of lifts the brow. It adds a little bit of flair. I feel like it completes the eye look. And this, for my skin tone, is the perfect brow bone highlight. So I've been reaching for that a ton. Also had the Bite Daycation blush. This is so beautiful. I've mentioned that this is so similar to the Charlotte Tilbury blush wand in Pinkgasm. This is such a similar shade and a similar effect, especially when I want that like sunburnt blush look that I love so much. So overall, I really liked this basket. For this next rotation, I'm definitely thinking some different tones since, again, I did play with so many similar tones. I feel like a lot of my looks were similar. I want to do a blue wing. I want to do like a goldeny green and just play around with some different products. I'm excited to switch these out. I always get excited about this part. So let's go ahead and hop into the selection. Okay, for foundation, I definitely want to grab my Plain Jane foundation. I really like this one, and I haven't used it in a bit, and it's a powder, so it's really easy to work with, and I feel like it looks super natural, so I definitely want to put this in. For a primer, I do think I want to keep playing around with this one. This is from Hard Candy. It's their Sheer Envy Hydrating Primer. You guys saw me share this in my recent dupes video, and it's such a good drugstore primer, so I want to keep this one in. For another foundation, I do want to go ahead and put the e.l.f. back in. This is their Flawless Finish Foundation, and I'm pretty close to using it up, so I figured I might as well leave it in for a little bit longer. And I'm almost debating putting in a third foundation, which kind of seems like a lot, but I think I'm gonna do it. Let's go with this one. This is the Koki HD Skin Perfect. I wear the shade 20W. This is one of my favorites. Okay, as you can probably see, I keep my powders in this drawer now. So for my powder, I'm thinking let's go with the e.l.f. Halo Glow Powder. I wear mine in the shade Light Pink. This is such a great powder. It's a really great dupe for the Bare Minerals Mineral Veil. So I want to go ahead and put this one in. And that's going to be everything for the first drawer. Okay, moving into the second drawer. For concealer, I want to take this one from Urban Decay. This is their Stay Naked Concealer. I wear 30NN, which honestly is such a light shade for me. It's almost a little bit too light, even though 30NN in the foundation is like my perfect match. I probably could have gone with a different shade of this, but I do enjoy the formula. I'm gonna put that in. I think I'm gonna also put in this cream bronzer. So it's actually a concealer, but I use the shade as a cream bronzer. This is from Makeup Revolution. It's their Eye Bright Illuminating Under Eye Concealer. And I have the shade Caramel. And you guys saw me mention this in a couple dupes videos ago, because TikTok said it was a dupe for this one from Charlotte Tilbury, which it is not, but it's a really good product, so I'm gonna put that in. It's definitely more of like a warm bronzer shade, whereas the Charlotte Tilbury is more of a cool toned contour. But speaking of contour, I think I'm gonna put this in as well. I haven't had this in a while. This is my Fiona Stiles contour kit. They actually no longer sell this brand, but I did really enjoy this and I do still have it in my collection. So let's go ahead and put that in the basket. For my highlight, I wanna put in this one from Persona. Oh no, actually this one from Persona. So this is the Laguna highlight. This is the lightest shade of the three that they have as highlights. And weirdly, I find Laguna to be a little bit more subtle than Zuma. And lately, that's kind of more of what I'm into, so I'm gonna put this one in. And then that's the only highlight that I'm gonna take, since I do also have my Project Pan highlight. But for a blush, let's stick with Persona. I wanna put in Georgia. This is such a beautiful pinky peach blush. I really love this one, so I'm gonna put in that one. Plus, I have my Project Pan blush. Do I do a third blush, like maybe a cream blush? This is tough. No, I think that's gonna be good for blush. So I think that's gonna be everything from this drawer. We got blush, bronzer, highlight, concealer. Yeah, that's all I wanna take from this drawer. Okay, now we're into the lip drawer. Now I will say, I did just get the new Urban Decay Vice lipsticks. They sent me a few shades in the mail, so I'll probably mostly be testing those out because I wanna let you guys know if the formula compares to the original Vice lipsticks, which you guys know have been one of my favorite lipstick formulas for years. But with that, let me also throw in, I can't believe I'm gonna do this. I keep putting this in rotation after rotation. Like I've had this in so many times recently, but let's do it again. I love it. NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in London. This is like one of the oldest lip products ever. I mean, it's not old to me, but it's been around forever. But there's a reason it's still like a cult classic. It's such a beautiful shade that matches everything. And you guys know I put in that bright orange last time, but I did not end up wearing it. So I think I'm gonna skip a bold lip this time. We'll see, maybe halfway through I'll reach for one. You know, I've got some like more colorful looks, like green and blue looks in mind. So I'm wanting to pair that with something more neutral. So let me take, which one is it? This one, Manila from Ofra. This is such a beautiful nude liquid lipstick. And I feel like, again, it matches with a lot of different looks. So I'm gonna put that in. And lately I have been wearing those two lip oils, the one from ColourPop and Sigma, most days. So I think with those staying in my basket, I'm not really gonna need to grab anything else from this drawer. So that was pretty quick for lips, but I do have some others that you'll probably see me wearing the next few weeks. And for my palette selection, I'm gonna go ahead and go with these three. So I wanted to grab Sigma Untamed to satisfy my need for some colorful shadows. So I'm picturing a blue look, I'm picturing a green look, maybe even like a red look, some purple looks. Like I'm anticipating that this will be the palette that I reach into the most this next rotation. I just feel like I'm going to do a lot with this, but it's up my alley. You guys know when I play with color, I still like it to be muted, and that's what this palette does. And I feel like this palette is just so me. And these are the looks I'm craving, and I'm so excited to use this. So had to put this in. This was like top of my list. But I've also been wanting to do something with Naked Honey for a little bit now. I've been thinking about this palette, and I saw a look the other day that I wore years ago wearing this, and I was like, I have to put that in. I think I want to do something yellow. Of course, use some of the beautiful neutrals in here. So also so excited to use this. But the third look I've kind of been envisioning is something mauve. So I thought it is time to put ColourPop Making Mauves back in. It's neutral, but I could go a little bit more purple with it if I wanted to. And the purples in here, for some reason my lighting is not, I feel like, doing these justice right now, but the purples in here are gonna look so beautiful with the mauves. And then these orangey yellows will be so beautiful with the middle of this palette. So I feel like these combos, all three together, are gonna be really fun. Okay, I'm very excited about this new basket. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one.